Let's move on. That is exercise 2.2. Okay, first problem. If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, you will get 1 by 8. We want to find what is that number. Okay, how to solve these type of problems? According to this question, if you subtract, we want to subtract 1 by 2 from a number. So, we don't know what is that number. So, take it as x. So, let the number be x. Let the number be x. Okay, we want to subtract 1 by 2 from x. What is it? X minus 1 by 2. Okay, this want to be multiplied by 1 by 2. We want to multiply 1 by 2 the entire set. Okay, we get what? 1 by 8. Okay, we want to solve this linear equation. How to solve this? 1 by 2 into x minus 1 by 2 equals 1 by 8. First, we apply distributive law. 1 by 2 into x. Okay? 1 by 2 into x. How to multiply? 1 into x by 2. 1 into x means x by 2. That is x by 2 minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. How to multiply two rationals? We multiply numerators and denominators separately. Yes, 1 into 1 by 2 into 2. What will we get? 1 by 4. That is 1 by 4 equal 1 by 8. Yes, then x by 2 minus 1 by 4 equal 1 by 8. Yes, variable part is remind here. X by 2 equal 1 by 8 minus 1 by 4. After equality sign, what will we get? Plus 1 by 4. Okay, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4. Different denominator, so we want to find their LCM. So, 8 and 4. What is its LCM here? LCM equal 8. So, 8 into 1 by 8 plus 8 into 1 by 4 whole divided by 8. Okay, 8 cancelled here. 4 in 8, 2 times. What will we get? That is 1 plus here, 1 into 1, 1 plus 2 into 1, 2 divided by 8. 2 plus 1, 3 by 8. Okay, so x by 2 is 3 by 8. So what is x here? 3 by 8, here division. So, after equality sign, what will we get? Multiplication into 2. How to multiply one rational and a whole number? We multiply the numerators only, yes? So, that is equal 3 into 2 divided by 8. That is equal 6 by 8. These two numbers are common in 2, yes? So, after simplification, what will we get? 3 by 4 is the answer. Okay. If you want to check it, please substitute these value of x, that is 3 by 4 in place of x. We get 1 by 8. I think it is clear. Next problem, second problem. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meter. Its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. What are the length and breadth of that pool? Okay, how to solve? The perimeter. Before entering into this question, first we want to know what is the perimeter of a rectangle. Yes, solution. Solution. Perimeter of a rectangle is what? That is 2 into L plus B is what? 154 meter. Yes, perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into L plus B. Area of a rectangle is L into B. Here, perimeter of a rectangle. That is 2 into L plus B equal 154. Okay, then what about length and breadth? Here, length and breadth is unknown. So, length is L is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. So we take breadth as x. Okay. So what about length? That is 2 more than twice its breadth. Twice its breadth means 2x. So length is 2 plus 2x and breadth is x. Okay. Substitute these values in here. What will we get? 2 into L means what? 2 plus 2x plus B means what? X equal 154. Okay. So 2 plus 2x plus x equal 154. Here multiplication. So after equality sign it becomes division. Divided by 2. What will we get? 154 divided by 2. 7 2's are 14. Again 4 here. 77. Okay. So 2 plus 2x plus x equal 77. 2x plus x. X means here what? That is 3x. That is 3x plus 2 equal 77. Okay. 3x equal 77 minus 2. What will we get? That is 3x equal 77 minus 2 is 75. Okay. Then x equal what? 75 divided by 3. What will we get here? 2, 3 are 6 here. 5, 5. So 25 into 3 is 75. That is x equal 25. So we get breadth is 25. X here breadth. So x equal 25. What about its length? That is 2 plus 2x. That is equal 2 plus 2 into here 25. Okay. That is equal 2 plus 25 into 2 is 50. That is equal 50 plus 2, 52. Therefore, length is 52 and x here taken as breadth. That is equal 25. I think it is clear. Okay. Third problem. The base of an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter. So first we draw one isosceles triangle here. What is the speciality of isosceles triangle? Two sides are equal. Okay. So base is, the measurement of base is 4 by 3. Okay. So the perimeter of the triangle is, so the perimeter of an isosceles triangle is given, that is 4, 2 by 50. So these two sides are equal. So we want to find the length of either of the remaining equal sides. So we take one side is x. This is same as this. So here is x. Okay, because these two sides are equal. What is the perimeter? That is sum of these three measures equal 4, 2 by 15. Okay. So what will we get? X plus 4 by 3 equal 4, 2 by 15. Okay. X plus x, 2x plus 4 by 3 equal. It is a mixed fraction. How to convert to improper fraction? 15 into 4 is 60. Yes. 60 plus 2, 62. 62 by 15. Okay, 15 into 4 here, that is 5 4s are 20, balance 2, that is 60, 60 plus 2, 62. Okay, the next one, 2x equal 62 by 15 minus 4 by 3 after equality sign minus 4 by 3. Denominators are different, so what is their LCM is 50 because 3 is one of the factor is 15. Therefore, the greatest number is the LCM. Okay. That is 15 is the LCM. 15, what will we get? 1, 5. So, 5 here, 1, 1. So, 15. So, what is its LCM here? 15 into LCM is 15. Okay. So, 15 into 62 by 15 minus 15 into 4 by 3 whole divided by 15. 15 cancelled here and 5 here, that is 62 minus 20 by 15. 62 minus 20 what? 42. That is 42 by 15. Yes? Then 2x equal 42 by 15. So what is x here? 42 by 15 divided by 2. That is 42 by 15 into 2 means 2 by 1. Multiplies with reciprocal into 1 by 2. We get 42 by 30. These two numbers are common in 2, 3, 6. Yes. So we get divided by each part is divided by 6. What will we get? 7 divided by 5. If you want to convert it as mixed fraction, 7 by 5 is the one of the part, because 42 and 30 is common in 6. Okay, divided by 6. What will we get? 7 by 5. So we get 7 by 5. Okay, I think it is clear.